In the movie, there's a pretty good bond between the both of you, right? How did you guys prepare for that? Did you guys get to hang out before you actually started filming?
Yeah, we did. Yeah, he like baked me cookies and all that stuff. I don't know. We just hung out. We just had a good time.
Inside jokes and pranks and
it was fun. It was good to have his energy on set, you know, because he's just really easygoing and, you know, more fun. We had more fun on his days filming, typically. When he came in, it was like, yes, Charlie's in the day. Thank God. It's going to be fun.
I heard that there was a lot of pranks on High School Musical, so there were a lot of pranks on set between you two, or was there other people involved as well?
I don't know. It sort of just happens.
Yeah.
There's a lot of hurry, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, and wait, you know, and the waiting part gets really boring. So we had a pretty lively, fun crew. You know, they figured out a lot of ways to make interesting pranks, and they were, I don't know, we had quite a few.
Were there any in particular that were funny that you guys remember?
The one where the guy pretended to be a paparazzi.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot about that.
We were filming on an indoor stage. Well, okay, so basically I had this scene. It was like we had a love scene in a graveyard. It was rehearsals for it, but we were going for it, and it was before the sun had went down. And there was this paparazzi in a full ghillie suit, like looking like Predator, and a big camera, and I saw his lens, and I pointed him out. And like it was a big deal, and you know, I don't know. From that point on, it was like a big inside joke that there were paparazzi everywhere. So one time we were filming inside on the stage, and one of the guys in the crew dressed up in like a same kind of ghillie suit, which is a camouflage suit, and hid in the bushes indoor on the stage, and hid and started clicking pictures, and I heard like a camera going off. I'm going, the heck? What is that?
I
looked up in the bushes.
Everyone's like flipping out.
Everyone's freaking out, and of course they were in on it. But I was tripping because there were paparazzi had supposedly snuck in on stage and was hiding in an indoor stage. So they got me pretty good.
So they did a good thing. Well, you mentioned some of the more emotional scenes, the love scene. How was it for you? What did you have to do to prepare for those scenes?
Well, it wasn't really much like preparation for the whole sadness thing. Like, sort of having fun, kind of being in the moment, I guess. I
tried to think in the circumstances of, you know, how it is, how it would be if I have a real little brother. If my little brother, you know, who's a lot like him, if he was going through these scenarios, how I would feel.
So for you guys then, you have a lot of fans. What do you want your fans to take away from this movie? Why should they go see it?
You know, this movie has strong family values. You know, everyone at some point experiences loss. Even though the person has moved on, they're very much alive inside our hearts. They're still there guiding us. So that's a great message, you know, and I hope the fans walk away with an understanding.
Awesome.
Thanks,
man. Well, thank you very much.
Thanks, man.